Hey there, thanks for joining me today. Here's a fun shoot I did for a local talent agency. I love doing these shoots with them because one, they're always fun to photograph, and two, since it's trading time for prints, I get to share the work with you guys here on YouTube. Let's take a look at this. The talent agency is JNM Talent. This was a holiday shoot. Let's talk about this simple lighting setup using one big 5-foot umbrella with a diffusion cloth. And instead of strobes, I'm using an LED light. And why do I love LED lights? Because look at how huge the iris is when you use LED lights. You see all the color in the eye because the pupil is very small because of the bright light. So you see so much more color in the iris. It's something I love to do when I can control the ambient light on the set. Let's take a look at kind of a fun holiday picture. I'm gonna just scroll down a little bit. And let's do one of these. Let's see, let's just take this image and we're going to reset it. Now we have the default view, the image straight out of the camera. Let's make a fun holiday or winter image. And if we notice, it's ISO 800, 1/200th of a shutter speed at 2.5. So settings for this actually work real well. Obviously, if I was using strobe, I'd be down at ISO 100, but my LED lights aren't super bright. ISO 800 is still going to give me a very clean image on the Canon EOS R5. Okay, so our image is reset. And let's just take it into develop by hitting the letter D for shortcut. And I'm going to close up Brilliance AI and go straight into tone. Step one always for me is picking a camera profile. I'm going to look at a couple. So if that's faithful, neutral, portrait, and standard. Not a huge difference, but portrait does really pop the reds a little bit in her dress. So I'm going to start off there. We'll look at our levels in the upper right corner. And skin tone is really nice right there. Happy with how that is looking. So exposure is right on. White balance is really close. It was a custom white balance, but I may just cool it down a little bit because it is kind of a snowy scene. I'm going to drop that down a little bit there. And next, to make it a winter photo, or something perfect for a holiday card, let's just add some snow. Go into effects, add a filter, add texture, click on the more button, and select snow. And then we'll have a few different versions. So there's accumulation, alpine, blizzard, catch one on your tongue, and it's coming down there. Playing around with these, I'm going to do catch one on your tongue. And then the last thing I'm going to do is just mask it off part of her face. So all we have to do is click on the mask icon, select B for brush, and we'll just make sure it's set to erase. Opacity is at 100, increase the brush size, and just kind of get off her face. Might leave that on the cheek. That doesn't really bother me, but that's looking really nice. Last thing you can do is under the opacity, you could make the snow stand out a little bit more if you want. Awesome! So easy to make a fun holiday or winter image. So that was so easy. But what if things don't go quite according to plan? Denied. Let's scroll down a little bit. Here we had some fake snowballs. And what we were trying to do is have it so we're throwing snowballs at Daisy here. And we wanted her like covered and going, ah, like she's screaming, she's about to be hit. So Daisy's mom threw the balls and I was trying to time it So you can see the mom's hand in here, and Daisy was doing great. But what always happens is right when the balls were falling in the perfect place, Daisy naturally closed her eyes. So after multiple tries, we're just not getting what we wanted all in one image. And part of photography is troubleshooting through a portrait session. So I saw that if we merged probably 3 or 4 images, we could have the perfect shot. Let's back out of here. Like, for example, I love how the balls are down here. I wanted one where the balls are a little bit higher. So here now we're getting where the balls are high and falling, and then some where they're low. And then if we just have one with a nice expression with her eyes open, it's gonna make a great shot. So let's go into my retouch photos and we'll look at the ones that I picked out for this. So I did 3 different versions of this, but one of them that we'll go over right now is this one. It's a layered image and it's made up of 3 different images. I'm using the face of number 248. I am using the upper balls of 259. That's actually my base image, so that's going to be at the very bottom of my stack. And then 262, I like these balls at the very bottom. So again, the base image is this one, and then we're going to add the balls from this one, and we're going to use the face from this one. So let's just open this up. You can see how it was done. If you want a more in-depth tutorial on actually masking out everything, just let me know in the comments and we'll do a more in-depth tutorial on creating this composite. Hit the letter D and you can see how it was done. So 3 images used. Let's just start with that base image, right? That has the perfect balls up top. So the snowballs at the bottom look great. All we need to do is change the face. And with that layer, I masked out everything and then just painted in the face. So we got the great expression. Final step was to make a stamped version. So that combines all 3 layers into 1 top layer. And that way we can add the snow by going onto that layer, going into effects, doing just what we did earlier, going down to textures, going down to more, selecting snow, and this one, let's just do this, the weather snow light. And again, I'm going to take it off her face a little bit by clicking on the mask icon, hitting the letter B for brush, and we'll just paint it out a little bit off her face, and then hit check. And we are done with that image as well. Kind of a winter wonderland look. Easy to do. And again, by using the LED lights, we have lots of color in her eyes. We have a big catch light from the 5-foot umbrella. Just a very simple way to light a portrait that looks amazing. Hope you enjoyed this quick tutorial. If so, be sure to subscribe, share with your friends. I'm trying to build this channel and getting so close to 1,000 subscribers. This is exciting. Leave a comment if you have any questions, or again, if you do want me to follow up and slow down on the masking part and take it step by step, happy to do that tutorial for you. All the best, and until next time, keep shooting.